Naturalized areas can add value to a golf course by improving aesthetics, reducing maintenance, and creating habitat for wildlife. Since the appearance and playability of naturalized areas can vary depending upon the purpose it serves, it is critical for expectations to be clearly defined. A desire to conserve resources is often the driving force behind establishing naturalized areas. By suspending routine maintenance practices like weekly mowing, regular irrigation, and fertilization, truly naturalized areas can be created. This makes it possible to focus resources where play is most likely to occur. However, allowing the existing turf to grow and turning off the water is not likely to produce the thin, wispy appearance often envisioned by golfers. Since frequent mowing is an effective form of weed control, weeds will encroach once mowing stops. Keep in mind, what may be considered a weed by some can attract new wildlife. Take milkweed, for example. Monarch butterflies will be attracted to naturalized areas if milkweed is growing. The program Monarchs in the Rough aims to increase habitat for monarch butterflies by supporting the establishment of milkweed on golf courses. Also, if there are sources of nectar and pollen, pollinators will be attracted to naturalized areas. Promoting habitat for pollinators may not exactly be what golfers imagined with naturalized areas, but the importance of being good environmental stewards can't be overstated. Maintaining thin, wispy naturalized areas can add architectural value, but it requires a significant investment to manage turf density and keep these areas free of weeds. Not to mention, the soil and climate will have a major influence on the overall performance and aesthetics, even when a considerable amount of resources are dedicated to meeting this expectation. Naturalized areas do not need to have thin, wispy turf, or much vegetation at all. The climates of certain regions make it possible to use sand, gravel, or even mulch in naturalized areas. Determining the exact location for naturalized areas can take some time. You'll probably be able to identify general locations of where play is limited, but adjustments may be necessary. Some facilities have utilized technology in the form of GPS trackers to pinpoint areas of the course golfers rarely use. Conditions in naturalized areas can vary from region to region, course to course, and even within the same course. It doesn't matter whether naturalized areas are established to reduce inputs, create habitat for wildlife, or add architectural strategy. Each method can bring added value to golf courses.